Good morning, students. Today we shall discuss the president and the vice president of India. We shall try to make a comparative study of the positions, qualifications, elections, terms, and removal of the president and the vice president of India. We shall try to understand it with the help of a table. So when I am making a table, you can try to understand, and in the examinations you don't have to make the same table. This is for you to understand. All of you know the president of India is named the president of India Sri Ram Nath Kovind. He is the 14th president of our country, and his position, he is the highest authority . So the president is the highest executive authority. He is the head of the state. And he is the supreme commander of armed forces. This is the position of the President of India. What about his qualifications? Who can become the President of India? What eligibility is required to become the President of India? A citizen of India. He should be 35 years old. He should be qualified to be a member of Lok Sabha. And he should not be holding any government post. These are the qualifications required to become the President of India. So now let's see what about the Vice President. What is his position? And the name of the Vice President is Sri Venkaiya Naidu. He is also the 14th Vice President of our country, and he is the second highest position to the President. So he had the second highest position. Next to the president. So president is the first citizen of India. The vice president is the second citizen of India. And he is the ex officio chairman of Rajya Sabha. So this is the position of the vice president of India. So you can always compare. And his qualification. In case of the president of India, person should be citizen of India. He should be at least 35 years old and he should be qualified to be a member of Lok Sabha and he should not be holding any government post. The same qualifications are required for becoming the Vice President of India also. So we can say first qualification, a citizen of India. Second qualification, he should be 35 years old. Third qualification, he should be qualified to become a member of Lok Sabha. And fourth, he should not be holding any government post. So as far as qualifications are required, the same qualification to become the President of India and to become the Vice President of India are required. So this comparison you can understand. And the next point is, how do we elect the president and how do we elect the vice president? Election of the president, elected indirectly. An electoral college. Electoral college consists of MPs of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. The electoral college includes MLAs of various states and union territories. So the President of India is elected by an electoral college consisting of the members of Lok Sabha, members of Rajya Sabha and members of the state legislative assemblies. What about the elections of the Vice President? Vice President is also elected by an electoral college. So he is also elected by an electoral college consisting of the members of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. So here you can see the Vice President elected only by the members of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. The MLAs of various states and union territories do not take part in the election of the Vice President. That is the only difference. Then we have last one is the terms of the President and the Vice President. That means for how many years President is elected, for how many years Vice President is elected. The term of the President is 5 years. The terms of the Vice President also 5 years. Both are elected for a period of 5 years. Of course, they can be re-elected. They can be given another term also. All depends upon the electoral college. Whether the electoral college will re-elect them for another term or not. But they are eligible to contest the election for the second term also. So far we have only Dr. Rajendra Prasad who completed 2 terms. All the other presidents, they had only 1 term, that is 5 years. And last one is the removal. The removal of president and vice president. The president is removed by impeachment. Last class I explained to you what impeachment is. So president is removed by impeachment for violation of the constitution. So here the one house will level charges against the president and other house will investigate those charges. If the other house finds the charges true, then president will be removed. This is called impeachment. So president is impeached by the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. What about the vice president? The vice president is not impeached. But vice president is removed when the Rajya Sabha will pass a resolution. If the Rajya Sabha passes a resolution against the vice president, and the Rajya Sabha will send the information to the Lok Sabha. So that is the procedure to remove the vice president of India. So these are the different points with regard to the president and with regard to the vice president. Many things are similar, at the same time few things are different, which you should clearly understand and know, so that you don't get mixed up when the question comes about the president or about the vice president. So I hope you have understood the table, and this table is to help you to understand the election, the position, the qualification and removal of president and the vice president. In the second part, we will discuss the powers of the president and the powers of the vice president.